The seven principles of universal design are equitable use, flexibility in use, simple and intuitive use, perceptible information, tolerance for error, low physical effort, and size and space for approach and use. These principles were developed in the mid-1990s at North Carolina State University by a group of architects, engineers, product designers, and researchers. Today, the principles of universal design have been translated into multiple languages and adapted worldwide. But what do all of these principles mean? Let's start by defining each of the principles individually and how they relate to design. The first principle of universal design is equitable use, meaning the design is useful and marketable to people of all abilities. Some good examples of this first universal design principle are zero threshold or no stop entrances and automatic doors, because they enable everyone the independent use of the same entry.
Zero entrance, just to name a few. But these simple designs gave me access to places that would be inaccessible to me.
Flexibility in use is the second universal design principle. For a design to follow this principle, it must accommodate a wide range of individual preferences and abilities. Scissors that can be used by right and left-handed users, and adjustable desks or tables are examples of this principle in use. The third universal design principle is simple and intuitive use. A design meets this principle when its use is easy to understand, regardless of the user's experience, knowledge, language skills, or current concentration level. Picture icons on a smartphone or tablet are examples of simple and intuitive use, as these help users who speak different languages or have varying communication skills utilize a design the same way without a list of complicated instructions.
So we think of people whose language may not be, their first language may not be English, for instance. We also think of someone with maybe a cognitive or learning disability, maybe dyslexia. So breaking down information into bite-sized chunks and making it more accessible for everyone is going to benefit the entire population.
The fourth principle of universal design is perceptible information. This means the design communicates necessary information effectively to the user, regardless of ambient conditions or the user's sensory abilities. In other words, can I hear it? Can I see it? Can I feel it? Can I smell it? High contrast paint on floors, tactile buttons on elevators are an example of this principle. Tolerance for error is the fifth universal design principle. For a design to fall under this principle, it must minimize hazards and the adverse consequences of accidental or unintended actions. A double-sided key is an example of tolerance for error. The sixth principle of universal design is low physical effort. A design meets this principle when it can be used efficiently and comfortably and with a minimum of fatigue. Examples of low physical effort are motion-sensing lights that turn on as someone enters a room. The seventh and final universal design principle is size and space for approach and use, meaning the design must be appropriately sized and spaced for approach, reach, manipulation, and use, regardless of a user's body size, posture, or mobility. Good examples of this principle are doorways or turnstiles at least 36 inches wide that can accommodate wheelchairs, rolling luggage, strollers, and shopping carts.
I've often heard people in this building say, "I don't feel like I have a disability when I'm here," because it's not sort of being constantly reminded to you, you can't do this, you can't do this, you can't do this. In this building, you can do it. You know, people can use the building.
Though there are multiple principles, it is important to not focus on only one for a single design. Though some of the guidelines of each principle may be more relevant than others, designers should strive to apply all of the principles into any one design. A sprinkling of everything rather than all of one and none of another. This video was produced for the Rehabilitation Engineering Research Center on Technologies to Support Aging in Place for People with Long-Term Disabilities, RERC TxAge, and the Disability Rehabilitation Research Project on Universal Design Practices to Enhance Work Outcomes, DRRP on UD in the Workplace by the Center for Inclusive Design and Innovation, Georgia Institute of Technology, and Tools for Life, Georgia's Assistive Technology Act program. RERC TxAge and the DRRP on UD in the Workplace are supported by grants 90REGE006 and 90DP0049 from the National Institute on Disability, Independent Living, and Rehabilitation Research, NIDLR. NIDLR is the center within the Administration for Community Living, ACL, Department of Health and Human Services, HHS. The contents of this video do not necessarily represent the policies of NIDLR, ACL, or HHS, and you should not assume endorsement by the federal government.